Michelle, Yeye's Corner, and in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys a what's in my bag video. So basically, I have the Louis Vuitton Neverfull MM bag, and this is in the Damier, Ebene print. I recently picked this up, and if you guys recently watched my last what's in my bag video I filmed about like 3 weeks ago, you guys would have heard me say that it kind of, the tote bag that I was showing you guys reminded me of Louis Vuitton Neverfull and how I always wanted one. And I finally got one. I literally got one like a week after filming that video, which was crazy. So my bag is actually pre-loved, but it is an authentic bag. I went through the process and made sure it was authentic and everything like that. So I was able to get it for really, I was able to get it for a really good price, and I'm very happy about my bag. So let's get straight into it, because I've wanted this bag for 5 years. I've been carrying it now for about 2 or 3 weeks, so we're gonna see what I've collected in here. So I did decide on the MM size because I feel like the medium size goes perfect with everything. This is how it hits on me. So it hits like on my waist. I feel like it's the perfect size. I feel like the PM is too small. And I went to the Louis Vuitton store and I found out that they no longer make the PM size, which is the smallest. And then GM, I just feel like it's way too big. So let's get into this. So basically, I have my little, I always forget what this is called. This is authentic as well. I actually bought this one from the Louis store. I just keep this attached to the strap just to make it a little easier, because I kind of lose it in here since it is a Neverfull. It's kind of easy to lose stuff in your bag. So I keep this attached, and basically I just keep all of my cards inside of here. So that's very helpful. Then I always keep the bag like clasped. So I keep it closed just so it's a little easier, so people aren't able to reach into it. So when I purchased this bag, this is the 2011 edition. I did my research on it, because if you guys know, the newer editions, it's just plain stripes inside. But the 2011 editions, they have like more of the designs inside. Like, it's just not plain. Okay, so mine didn't come with the little pouch that you can detach. So I put the pouch that was in my other purse in here. So it's just my XOXO Victoria's Secret pouch. So I just clasped it to the inside loop. So inside of my makeup bag, I'm just gonna start with that first. Let's see what's in here. And if the walls are echoing, if you hear an echo, that's because I moved into my new apartment and there's no furniture in here really, so yeah. So first thing I have is a Home Depot stain remover pin. I have a pad for emergencies, some hand sanitizer from Bath & Body Works, my favorite lip gloss that I have on right now, the e.l.f. Champagne Glam Gloss, some baby lips, Victoria's Secret Sunset Flavored Gloss, and a little sample of perfume from Sephora. I believe this is the Flower Bomb. And I just basically keep this kind of stuff inside of the makeup bag, because I don't want to get the inside of my bag dirty. I want to keep it nice and clean and stain free, because the condition that this bag came in for it to be pre-loved is amazing. Like, there was no stains whatsoever inside of it, and the person kept the bag really, really nice and clean. So next, I have my Michael Kors wallet. I plan on getting a Louis Vuitton wallet soon, just so I can match everything in the flow. But I have my Michael Kors wallet that I really love. Then next, I have this little power bank charging phone case, which I need to recharge because I used it yesterday, and so all the juice in it is gone, but I need to recharge it. These are so handy when you're out and it's just like an emergency. So next, I have my taser in case I need to go there with somebody, but I haven't had to use it. I've had it for like 2-3 years now, so I'm blessed I haven't had to use it. So yeah, next I have my keys. Yeah, it's pretty basic, some pepper spray, my car keys, my house keys, so that's on there. Next I have my Fenty lip gloss, which is supposed to be in my pouch, but that's my favorite gloss as well. Like, Rihanna, you did it with that lip gloss, it's bomb. So next I have this e.l.f. bag because I did a return the other day and I just threw it back in here. There's nothing in here. I'm probably going to throw it away. I know you can reuse them, but I have so many of these because every time you go to e.l.f. they give you these bags. And then next I have this air freshener that I have to put in my car. It's like a Chanel inspired air freshener. It's super cute. My boyfriend bought me this from Nordstrom Rack, so it's really cute. And then at the bottom I just have a quarter and three loose bobby pins and a thing of trash. I'm actually gonna empty this out so that my bag's not messy. So then you have this flap that's in the bag. So in the flap I have these pictures from this party that me and my sister went to yesterday. We went to a birthday party and they had a little cute little photo booth. So we took pictures in that, super cute. And then I have, I got some money. I need to put that up. My purse is a mess. Okay, then I have my Anastasia Beverly Hills compact mirror. I love this thing, super cute. This is from my Ulta days when I worked there and I got this as gratis. And then I just have this random receipt. I have bought a dust mop from DD's Discounts yesterday. And then I just have my Tweezerman tweezer for when you pluck hairs. So yeah, that's basically all that's in my Louis Vuitton Neverfull. I hope you guys all enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel as well. And I will see you guys all in my next video. Bye guys.